Strong results, and I am happy to present this Q1 financial results to our investors and to the press. So the bank, again, as you can see from the press note, it has posted a healthy growth in all segments. And let us start at the beginning. I think net profit is what it has been the highest strong point of this quarter. The net profit is now 365 crores as compared to the 209 crores of the corresponding quarter last year, which is an increase of 75%. And this is also due to the fact that there is a arresting of fresh slippages, a better recovery performance, and also a boost in the other income, which grew by 58%. The other important parameter, the return on assets, is now improved to 0.52%, which was 0.33% a year back. And the return on equity also improved from 5.32 to 9.06%. The domestic NIM is at 2.85. The bank's total business recorded a 14% increase. And this was with a backing of deposits growth of 15% and an advances growth of 12% over year on year. The loan book is well diversified. It was 58% last time when we met. Now the RAM was 58%. Now it is 60%, with corporate being the 40%. The growth in the retail, agriculture and MSME sector has been very well pronounced, with 24% in retail, 25% in agriculture and 10% in the MSME sector year on year. The accelerated recovery and upgradation efforts that the bank has been working on for quite some time now have all come together, and as can be seen in the present quarter, the accretion to the fresh NPAs has been 1,034 crores, and this can well be compared with the last year's figure of 1,391 crores in the corresponding quarter last year, and also in the Q2 last year, which was 2,250 crores. And I am not going through the presentation, I am just highlighting the highlights so that, you know, we can go through the presentation. I just want to share some of the highlights. The healthy build-up of the provision coverage ratio is now 66.34%. And the slippage ratio is at 2.47%, and credit cost now comes to 1.04%. I think all this augurs well, and this can all be seen in the capital adequacy that has now come to 13.62%. This is a very strong capital ratio, and this was boosted by the 295 crores that was raised through the employee stock purchase scheme. So these are the major highlights. And we will quickly go through the presentation. Available this year, despite that, there is a growth of 9.5% on interest income. Other income has been boosted almost 58%. And this is on the, you can see the profit on sale of investments. This has been helped by the lower yields this year. So there has been a churn in the investment portfolio. The recovery of bad debts has also been better. The fee income has improved, the forex income has improved, and PSLC commission, which we monetize the private sector loans that we are very strong on, that has added 50 crores year on year. The interest expenditure also has gone up because the deposits have gone up 15%, and a major portion of the deposit growth has come from our rapid rise in the term deposits. And so the cost of interest that we pay on the deposits, that has slightly gone up. The NII is at, again, 1,785 crores, better than the last quarter. But compared to the previous quarter, again, I was mentioning the 145 crores of the interest that we had written back on the Bhushan scheme exposure last year, this quarter. So adjusted for that, it's in the positive. The staff expenses have slightly gone up. This is also because of the, as I mentioned, the pressure on the yields. There is a requirement that we provide more on the pension funds, the actuarial calculations. So that has added to the staff cost. And also the employee share purchase scheme that we had done, the discount that was offered to the employees has been taken on the balance sheet this quarter. The overheads, again, the increase is partly because of the ATM charges and other DICGC premium. Everything that comes with the growth in business, other expenses also go up, so partly that is explained there. The operating profit, as you can see, there is a 6% growth at 1,374 crores. Here, the yields have been low, so that depreciation is not as much as, or the M2M loss is not as much as it was last year. And also we had taken the MTM hit on one or two accounts where we, one or two exposures where we had the investments in the bonds. The income tax is higher this year because there is no M2M loss that we could have taken towards income tax. So net profit, net, taking all these factors into account and riding on the higher interest income and also the other income, the net profit is improved 75% to 365 crores. These are the business figures which I already mentioned. Coming to the right side, the CASA percentage, as a percentage, CASA has come down. It is now 33.4. However, there has been a growth in the CASA, about 3.5% growth. But as I already mentioned, the term deposits have grown at 20%, and this was also consciously done. CASA, while we are trying to improve, it is also important that we build up the core deposit base and reduce the dependence on the high-cost CDs or the purchase deposits. And this term deposits will stand us in good stead for the coming quarters when the asset ramp-up will happen. And the agriculture sector, MSME is stable since March, and corporate, so yes, there has been a dip in the corporate exposure, but this is normally what is expected in Q1 of any year, and I'm sure the corporates, we have the pipeline, and these disbursements will happen in the coming quarters. That is when the corporate book will ramp up.